a lot of people don't want to get involved with black people because they see the self-hate within our own community, which I will never come to actually fully understand. My hair, she thinks, just bought it. I see it, I like it, I want it, I got it, yeah, I want it, I got it, I want it, I got it. Period. Hey YouTube, it's your girl, my lady Nova. I am not here to say anything funny today. I'm not here to talk about hair today. I'm not here for a wig review today. No, like, I'm here to discuss an actual serious matter. So if you came here for hair, if you came here for humor, if you came here for, I don't know, just anything of the above, you can click out and, you know, just dismiss yourself to where you actually came from. So I'm here today in regards to just me waking up to see old tweets that's resurfaced from influencers as well as artists or rappers, whatever you want to call them. And personally, as a black person, I feel disgusted. Let me just quickly point out that the noise in the background is thanks to my new cat Fendi, who decided to randomly pop babies, you know, unannounced. We didn't really know she was pregnant until the last 2 weeks, because, you know, she was the shape of a rugby ball, and she just decided to, you know, push out 5 kids, and now they're causing anarchy in my kingdom. So if you're wondering what the noise is about, that's what the noise is about. And here she is, attention seeking in my lap right now, but I'm just gonna let her sleep. Anyways, with that being said, a lot of tweets have resurfaced, and it's in regards to black people, more or less black women. One thing I will never understand is, you know, your black mother paid for your school uniform, for you to go to school, for you to live a normal life, for you to... Actually, no, she didn't only pay for your school uniform. She paid for your phone, for you to go home, use her electricity that she paid for, use her Wi-Fi that she paid for, and on that same phone with the same electricity she paid for, disrespect black women. From Yasmin Diaz, I think she's mixed race or light skin, whatever you want to call it, influencer. She probably does fashion, etc. Really pretty girl.
She said, quote unquote,
white girls are looking much better than mixed race girls and black girls. Don't understand. Some people really want to be black. I wish I was white. How about that? So the date of this tweet was, yes, I'm petty, so I will include the time, 14:12. So that's 2:12 p.m. the 30th of September 2012. So fair enough, she's at the age of 14. If she said the age of 12 11, slightly understandable, no excuse, but slightly understandable. She tweeted that at the age of 14. At the age of 14, there are girls having sexual intercourse and they know what they're doing. Yeah, so at the age of 14, I'm pretty sure you know whether you're being a misogynist. I'm pretty sure you know where, you know, you're deliberately trying to offend a race of people. And you know what's disgusting as well, I find it very funny that she's not only half white, but she is half black. You've come from a half black community, so her grandmother is probably black. Do you understand? So her saying things like this, like, to me, when a mixed race person says or has racist thoughts, I trace this back to their mothers. Like, I'm not saying it applies to all white mothers. A lot of white mothers do date black men for the sake of them being sexually appealing to them, in their opinion, as well as them fantasizing having caramel babies with curly hair. Like, this has come from a white person I know personally. I'm not saying it's how white women think, but a lot of black men are not acknowledging the fact that white women will date black men but still disrespect their black mothers. You can still date a black man, a black person in general, and be racist or appear to be a misogynist, and that's just not okay. Like, it's not okay. So for her to be raised, and in my opinion, I feel like she was raised with that mentality due to the fact where it's not just gonna come from nowhere. It is, stems from their surroundings as well as things they believe, things they're taught, ways they're raised. That's how everyone has and develops their own morals and principles. So I feel like, as for Yasmin, she has none. For that to even come out her mouth, knowing her father's probably black, because I'm going to assume her mum is white, she has no morals. Like, she has no sense of what is right and what is wrong. I don't think, you know, she had an actual brain cell in her head to tell her, like, you know, what are you doing? In regards to every single tweet, I wholeheartedly believe hers was the worst. and she genuinely wasn't sorry. She was just sorry she got caught. I don't know the girl personally, but from how I'm perceiving it, I don't think she's sorry. Those words and what she said, you know, I'm a Christian, so I believe in forgiving and forget. However, I just don't believe she was sorry. So she's cancelled. I'll be so real, I don't know who this person is. It says Michael Olusope. And they tagged at Ludo the Kid and at That Prick Frank. Is it rape? Is she black? Nah, it's animal cruelty. This worse. Like, that tweet literally, it didn't just grind my gears, it boiled my blood, it twisted and turned my gut. Like, that literally just made me feel enraged. Like, if 2020 was a person, it would be the person that made this tweet. Point blank period. So apparently rape, you know, and rape is a very serious thing because there's a lot of people that have been sexually coming from abused. A black man as well. What if someone's like, you see what I'm not understanding is, it's within the black community. What if someone was to say that about your black mother or your sister or your auntie? What if they happened to your auntie and the rapist excuse was, she's black, it was just animal cruelty? I just don't understand how such vulgarity can actually come out of someone's mouth, especially from the black community. And this is why other races think it's okay to be racist towards us, because we don't even show a good example ourselves. We don't even, like, the realness of it is, we don't even take care of our own communities. We don't look at the problems within our own communities, and that is just literally the sad truth. That is just the basic. Anyone that says otherwise, like, just don't kid yourself. Like, a lot of black people put black people down, even with black businesses. Black people do not support their own. They rarely ever support their own, and this is why other races laugh at us, and this is why majority of other races just look at us as a statistic. They don't look at us as individuals, they look at us as statistics, because that's how we're portrayed and that's the stereotypes we give into, whether we like it or not. It's true, like, we give into the stereotypes because we don't support our own, and we're quick to literally lick the bums of other cultures rather than build within our own. And that's just the sad truth. That's just the basic sad Keiji Keiki. Grew up listening to Paige Keiki a bit, right? So, end of the day, she's got black in her. And, you know, as a black person, you know how damaging and toxic the word is on, you know, ape or monkey. And she found it acceptable to not only disrespect someone that's black, but call their black mother an ape. She may not find this acceptable now, but she found it acceptable at the time. And stuff like that is just, this is not okay. 2013, so she was probably what, 15 16 17, so she probably knew right from wrong at the age of what, 10. We know not to do certain things. We know right from wrong, and it's facts. That part of me doesn't want to say she's cancelled, but the mum's ape thing, you're disrespecting someone's black mother, and it's, oh, you know, she's an ape. You know what, black, like, let's be real, the majority of black people are educated within the slave trade and what's going on. So you're finding it acceptable, so you're stooping down to their level. It is always your own people. Like, that's one thing that I'm going to live by. How does she look at her own black family members at the family gathering? Like, does she smile? Does she ask for extra potato salad? Does she look at them like monkey? Like, do you look at your black family members? Do you look at them in disgust? Do you look at them and think, pick the cotton? Do you look at them and think, wow, like, you've been through a lot, you deserve the world? Like, this quote is coming from someone called Toasted Lighty. I don't know who that is, but he said, you hardly ever hear someone say to a black girl, you light up my world. They're too black for that shit. So it's just like, wow. What? It's not even a lighty for one. Bear in mind, this was tweeted in 2013. I don't know his age, but this was tweeted in 2013. But you look like walking darkness. You look like a turned off light bulb, honey, you're dark. Another quote from my Ivorian Doll. Sometimes use a brush with your Brillo pad nappy head. I want to see her real hair. I want to see the 4C. I want to see the coils. I was thinking, you know what? Bless her. Like, bless her. Probably 100% fiber, 100% polyester, 100% cotton or whatever socks. I was thinking, bless her. Like, honestly, she's doing her thing. And now it's just like, right. And this was in 2014. So she, and look at her age. She knew what she was. For that to even come out your mouth, and you come from a black African household, cancelled. Cancelled. This is Nella, and this is something I really want to speak about. I've never understood the concept of pink lipstick on black girls. You gotta understand that some trends aren't meant for everyone to follow. Alright, so Nella doesn't wear nude. She doesn't wear pink lipstick. This was in 2013, so Nella Rose could not have been 13 years old, because there's no way Nella Rose is my age. I am 19 years old. So 2013, this tweet was in August. I would have been 12. There was no way she was my age. So she was probably 15 or 16. She knew what she was doing. Jamaican, Asian, coolie, African. So she said Jamaican, Asian equal coolie. African, Asian equals crossbred. Crossbreed, sorry. Do you know how, listen, you see with a lot of the Caribbean are mixed with different countries, right? But I could put my hands up and listen, proud. But I'm sorry. I'm sorry. That quote didn't make sense, right? Because all Jamaicans, all Caribbean people, I used to hate to admit, but all Caribbeans originate from Africa. So, because we're all crossbreeds. Make it make sense. On the bus full of Somalians, and it sounds like a fishmonger's market. Black girls complain too much. Females don't know how to act when it comes to awkward situations, so black girls act rowdy to distract the audience for the subject. White girls wear weave, black girls abuse it. This one slightly triggered me. Let me tell you why it's triggered me. I've got a lot of respect for Nella. Let me just point that out, point black period facts, right? Due to the fact of where I believe that she added substance on YouTube. Like, she came on YouTube with originality and substance, right? But I'm not going to say let me see your little hair, because I'm going to be real. A lot of black women, we do, like, little do people know. We actually do have hair, you know. Don't let the shrinkage fool you. We have hair. Our hair is thick. We could be diverse with our hair. We could do a lot of things with our hair. So I'm not even going to say that, yeah, because it has nothing to do with that. But Nella, I have seen you wear wigs a lot. Not a lot, a lot. So you must be talking about yourself with that one. Like, that's all I gotta say. With that one, you must be talking about yourself. From Tia and Wayne, if you're black, you have to have bun. And this was in 2011. And I'm pretty sure he was at 11 June 2011. So I'm pretty sure, you know, he knew what he was saying. So I've showed you the receipts. I've showed you the quotes. I don't think I've showed you from every influencer, but I'm just gonna keep it short and snappy. So I feel like with Nella, right, Nella's tweets weren't as bad as everybody else's, right? I'm gonna start off with Nella for a reason, right? She made a video as well as a public apology on, you know, YouTube, and she's deactivated her Instagram, right? I feel like it's for her sanity and her protecting her mental health, which is understandable, because when you sign up for social media, you sign up for a lot. You sign up for a lot of people knowing your business. You sign up for people wanting to know more about you, people to go digging, people to think they can have an opinion on your life or what you should do, shouldn't do. People thinking you're meant to set an example. People thinking you're perfect and that you can't act out. And let me just point out, no human being is in fact perfect. But the thing with Nella, right? I appreciate the apology. Right, I've watched her video or some of it. I've seen little snippets, and what I can say is, when she spoke on her being a certain age, she said she was around, I think, 13, 14. Hang on, she said she was. She said she was about 12 to 13, right? That means she's my age or 21. She's either 20 or 20. She's either 19, 20 or 21, because I'm 19 right now, right? And during 2012, during that day, I was 11 years old. Nella Rose's birthday is July the 20th, 1990. Another thing that being said as well, she also included the fact that she had a lot of self-hatred for being African, and she explained, you know, her truth. And that's one reason why I respect her apology and feel like it was the most genuine to an extent, due to the fact of where she explained her truth. And I understood her truth due to even me going to school, a lot of Africans would be disrespected and cussed in school. And it would be by Caribbean people, yes, but it would be by a lot of other people, to the point where I've even had African friends that will lie about their culture to escape the fact that they were embarrassed of their heritage, which is, there's nothing to be ashamed of. People speak down on Africa so much when Africa is literally the richest place in the world. Like, don't let, you know, what's happened, isn't it? Africa being stolen of their goods, Africa being degraded into nothing, when Africa is everything, was everything, and still is to this day. That's when we get our natural resources. Africa literally has everything. Don't let that fool you. Be proud of your motherland. Always be proud of where you came from, because that's who you are. And if you're not proud of where you came from, you can't be proud of who you are. So she explained at that point of time in her life that she wasn't happy, hence why she started saying what she was saying about, you know, black girls. It's not okay, but I've got an understanding due to the fact of where I've witnessed it for myself. And then she expressed when the trend of disrespecting Somalian girls came into place, she just quickly switched up. She just quickly switched onto them. And it's just the definition of, you know, you putting someone else down to make you feel better. But at the same time, I can have sympathy to an extent with Nella. I said to an extent with Nella due to the fact of where she's not a problematic person. I haven't really seen her get involved in any trauma. She just makes her YouTube videos and minds her own business, which I can say I respect. So within that, I can say she's shown self-growth as she's come to know who she is as a woman. And even with that being said, with Nella, I feel like she gave, it was a valid reason, but she gave an actual explanation for her actions. And everybody else, they didn't do that. She just said it was them being immature, it was them being this. You shouldn't be making it. She didn't make an excuse. She explained her truth. She didn't say it was her being immature. Like, she practically knew what she was doing, and she just said why she done what she done. But I also feel like people are dragging Nella for filth when, let's be real, what she said wasn't right, but there was much worse said. Yasmin needs to be held accountable for what she said, because out of all the women, what she said, as well as Ivorian Doll, is literally the worst. And I feel like, as well, if her apology was 100% genuine, I don't know whether she gets paid for that video she uploaded, but she wouldn't be getting paid for that video that she uploaded for the views. If she is getting paid for that video, which is a public apology, something she owes to the public, that is wrong. So this is my message to black men. Stop tearing down black women, especially when you've been raised and born by one. It's not okay. Like, it is not okay. Like, and it's hurtful due to the fact of where black men experience a lot of racism as well, whether it be by the police, by their own community. But they'd rather, instead of stick within the community and fix things and be the protectors that they were born to be, they just implicate that straight onto their black sisters, black mothers, black grandfathers, black daughters. And it's really damaging. Like, it's really damaged. A lot of black men feel like, make black women feel like they're not wanted, that they're nothing, and their excuse is black women are bitter. But no one's looking at the fact that the damage that they're doing to black women. They're just looking at reaction. We're not bitter, we're just tired, we're just hurt, we're just drained. Like, we have never felt accepted within our own community, and we want a change. That's all we want. We're not asking for you to have a type that's strictly only black women, because at the end of the day, your type is your type. But you don't have to slander black women in the process. Your type is your type. A lot of people that like Latinas, there's a lot of people that like Indian, like, that's okay. We don't care about your type. Have your type. You're entitled to having your type, but just do not slander your black sisters in the process. That's all we ask. That's literally all we ask. And black men, this is just, it's not, listen, let me just call it as it is. It is a warning. Please understand. Just please understand. Yes, all women are meant to have a nurturing nature, right? And black women are very nurturing. Like, we can be nurturers, but you cannot inflict pain and expect peace. But just please understand that every single white woman that goes for a black man is genuine. Like, don't get twisted. There's some that are actually genuine. Women do date black men for the simple fact that they want caramel kids. They want kids of a certain skin tone. They want kids of a certain hair texture, or, you know, because black men appear to be very sexualized within society. And I cannot stress that enough. Not everything that glitters is actually gold. Don't get twisted, there's genuine interracial couples that do genuinely love each other, but I find in most, the woman has something to say negative about black women, or the man has something to say about black women, which is just not okay. You can have your preferences, but you don't have to disrespect black women in the process. Black sisters, we do not need to change a thing about ourselves. We are beautiful. Sorry, that was my cat. Say hi to her, guys. She thinks we're beautiful.
Indeed we are. Indeed we are.
You can stop talking now, Fendi. Wait, now. So with that being said, black women understand that we are loved. If not by our own community, we are loved by ourselves. Self-love will be the most important love we can ever give ourselves. That comes first. With that being said, we don't need to change anything. There was a point where, let's be real, black people, we were laughed about within our features. Like, we were laughed about when it comes to our nose, our ears, our lips. Social media plays a big part in colorism. Men, not all men, some men are just going for the trend. If dark-skinned girls were to be a trend, men will be dropping like leaflets for dark-skinned girls. That's just how I feel. Like, that's just literally how I feel. Even with that being said, stretch marks, like, a lot of men looked at it with disgust, but since social media started bigging it up, it's sexy, it's appealing, it's this, it's that. And it's just like, do you know, like, even with big lips, do you know how much insecurities it's made girls grow up for having, and now it's being worshipped? It's just like, what the hell? Like, it's just, it's really damaging. Like, it really is. A lot of white women get their lips done. Don't get twisted, I know black women get their lips done too, but a lot of white women get their lips done. So I feel like a lot of black features will be worshipped on European women, but on a black woman, because of our skin, it will never be tolerated. And that's not fair. Like, black women, do not let that get to you, because at the end of the day, there's going to be someone that genuinely loves you for you regardless. Like, black people need to wake up, even black parents, because this is lockdown. This is literally just, this is a calling. This is a calling to all black people. Raise your child so they don't feel ashamed of where they come from. So no one should have to tell them, or so no one should have to bash them. If we stuck together the way we disrespected each other, we would be invincible. We follow the rules of society. When we are society, we make our own society, we are our own community. Because let's be real, other communities aren't going to claim us the way we will claim each other. But no, we choose to bash each other instead. And that's not okay. See, this is problems within the home. A lot of black children have these views and not on black people because of the self-hate that comes within their home. A lot of people will feel like the black sheep because they're the darkest in their family, and that needs to stop. A lot of people will feel like they're not loved because of the abuse that goes on in their family, and that needs to stop. A lot of people will feel like they're not good enough due to the fact of they don't know their own culture within their family, and that needs to stop. It's up to us black people to stand for what we believe in. It's up to us black parents. Oh, I'm not a parent, I've got a kid. Mom will kill me. Anyways, it's up to black parents to inject, and make their children inhale, squeeze it in if you have to, their roots. They need to know their roots. By all means, you need to teach and pass on their children your roots and teach them to be proud of who they are. Because a lot of this self-hatred comes from within the home, and it's also projected to them even more when they go out in the community. Yes, regardless, you can make your child fall in love within the home, and you can't control what happens to them within the community outside, but at least you as a parent know you have tried. At least you as a parent know you have inflicted that self-love of their black melanin skin within your child. So at least you can say you've done well with that. But regardless, I'm just going to conclude this video and say, black people, stop tearing each other down. This goes for everyone. This goes for me. This goes for everyone watching this. This goes for everyone watching this because it's not okay. That being said, thank you if you took your actual time to watch this video. I really appreciate it. Do not send any hate or negative comments to the people that made these quotes. At the end of the day, let's just be the bigger person. Let's just rise as a black community. Like, they were young at the time. It shouldn't be forgotten, of course, but it should be forgiven at the end of the day. We're not going to give in to the statistics of we're bitter people, we're angry people, we're negative people. We're going to uplift each other. What they've done was wrong, and they're black themselves, and all we can do is just correct them. And us correcting them, we don't have to do it vocally to them. We just have to show them we are who we are, and you know, we are proud of who we are at the end of the day, because the color of our skin isn't going to determine where we go in the afterlife. Our character is, our heart is. That's just something everyone needs to keep in mind. So with that being said, if you're new to the Nova Nation, please like, comment, subscribe. Comment, subscribe. I'll be doing more videos on my natural hair journey. So within the next video, I'm going to show you my hair process, talk about the products I've used, as well as, oh, hello, as well as give a little tutorial, maybe a bump for my face, as well as give a tutorial. To be honest, I'm just going to make my channel more diverse because I know my character. I know I've got a lot to offer more than just hair. So with that being said, please like, comment, subscribe, please share. If you agree, let me know. If you don't agree, please let me know. I'm always open to criticism, and I'm going to say again, please do not send any vulgarity to anyone I have mentioned in this video. It is not needed at the end of the day. This was in 2013, 2015. No, it shouldn't be forgotten, but it should be forgiven, and we are going to move on from this, and the only way we can is by coming together as a black community. So Nova Nation, bye!